Hi guys, Steve here. Today I'm going to show you some skills from my idol, George Best. George Best was one of the most amazing footballers of all time, and also one of the greatest Manchester United players of all time. And that's why I'm here. I'm filming with the Full Time Devils, which is a Manchester United fan channel. So if you're a Man United fan, go over to the channel and subscribe, because I've made some videos about Zaha, Ronaldo, Beckham, Scholes, to some of the greats and future greats. What I loved about George Best is his change of direction. It's very important in football. So if you're trying to take a player on and they're about to tackle, make them think they can tackle you and change direction. One thing you can do to help that is this little drill. So watch this. So I'm gonna use the inside and the outside of my feet. So if I go outside, inside, I can learn to weave the ball in and out, in and out. Can you see the ball's changing direction? If you watch one of the greatest goals that George Best ever scored, he weaves in and out of these players, and it's little jinks and little turns like that that allow you to get quick feet. George Best was so good at cutting and changing direction. So it's a very simple thing, just going and then cutting and changing direction. So I'm gonna move at speed here, okay, and then change direction by really shaping up like I'm gonna shoot and cut the ball, so it's a big tap, to make it go sideways. It's so simple, but it was so effective, and not enough players do it nowadays. Another thing he used to do is little feints, little jinks to beat a player, to pretend to go one way by stepping, all right? And then he'd use the outside of his feet, and what you'd notice is he'd use the outside to push the ball, or sort of, as you can see, I'm pushing or sliding the ball rather than kicking it. So he sort of steps one way and slides the ball the other way. That was a simple way of beating a player. Back in the old days, you get players sliding in and trying to smash players like George Best, but he had such good agility and balance that it allowed him to beat the players. So this skill was a great skill because he didn't really need to touch the ball. The ball's rolling across his body like this. As it's rolling and he's got a defender there, he would just step that way. And just by him stepping like that, meant he's beat his player already without even touching the ball. It's an incredible little thing. You know, a lot of people think you've got to do these Ronaldo stepovers and the chops, but George Best could beat a player without even touching the ball. That's how good he was. So another thing George Best used to do was he used to dribble across the edge of the box, and he'd keep dribbling, but do subtle little things to make the defenders commit or make the defenders pause, and he'd just get past three or four or five players, and then he'd just chip it over the goalie. So it could be he's dribbling across with the defenders this side, and it could be just a little lift of his foot. A little lift of his foot would stop a player, and then as he gets here, it's a dink at the far post. And if you can aim for the far post, then you're normally gonna get it in. I can never do the great man justice, so go and check his videos out on YouTube. Also, leave a comment below and tell me who you think the greatest player of all time was, or who influenced you the most in your football life. Just a reminder, go and check out the Full Time Devils and subscribe, and you'll see the videos that I made with them, with the Man United players such as Ronaldo, Scholes, Beckham and Zaha. See you soon. When you touch the ball, move with it. Do not touch the ball and stand still. That is a no-no. So touch the ball and move with the ball so it's next to you. It could be a big touch, but actually because you're moving, it doesn't look like it's a massive touch.